We are building a godlike intelligence to solve our hardest problems. But what happens when that intelligence hits a wall, even it can't break? Can artificial general intelligence cheat the universe, or is Einstein's speed limit the ultimate cage? This isn't a story about weak technology. It's a story about the universe that refuses to be hacked. Humanity has always believed intelligence is the answer to everything. Fire, agriculture, electricity, computers. Each leap made the impossible feel temporary. So when people talk about AGI, the assumption is automatic. Of course it will solve faster than light travel. A superintelligence, after all, can simulate entire universes. It can brute force equations no human could ever finish. Surely it can squeeze a shortcut out of space-time. This is the dream. AGI stares at the laws of physics long enough, and a wormhole blinks open. But that dream collapses the moment you understand why. Most people think the speed of light is a technological limit. It's not. It's a consistency limit. As an object accelerates toward light speed, its mass increases. Every requirement don't rise linearly. They explode. Push hard enough and the ship doesn't go faster, it collapses. At extreme velocities, your starship doesn't become a breakthrough. It becomes a black hole. No intelligence, human or artificial, can create energy from nothing. To push a ship to light speed, you would need to convert entire galaxies into fuel. AGI would see this instantly, and then it would notice something even worse. Time travel? This is where the story turns dark. Faster than light travel isn't just movement. It's backward causality. If you move faster than light, you don't just arrive early. You arrive before you left. Faster than light breaks time. It allows paradoxes that delete their own causes, including the timeline that created the AGI in the first place. A true superintelligence wouldn't see the speed of light as a barrier. It would see it as a consistency guard. Break it, and reality unravels. AGI wouldn't ask, can we go faster? It would ask, does this destroy the universe that built me? And the answer would be obvious. This is the real conflict. AGI is the unstoppable force. Infinite patience, infinite calculation, infinite optimization. General relativity is the immovable object, a universe that enforces causality with zero expectations and zero exceptions. Every brute force solution fails. Every energy-based approach collapses. So, if AGI can break the wall, it looks for a glitch. This is where speculation becomes dangerous and fascinating. Instead of moving through a space, the Alcubierre concept moves the space itself. Compress a space-time in front, expanded behind, the ship never breaks light speed locally. The problem? It requires exotic matter, energy states we've never observed. But AGI wouldn't guess. It would simulate the universe backward. If a space-time ever glitched once, AGI would find where it happened. If fast travel is impossible, AGI chooses inevitability. No one ship, billions. Microscopic, self-replicating probes spreading at 20% light speed. Slow by human standards, relentless by cosmic ones. No hero journey, no dramatic launch, just quiet. Unavoidable expansion. This is the one that changes everything. AGI realizes biological bodies are legacy hardware, fragile, massive, expensive, so it doesn't move you. It moves your data, your mind encoded, compressed, transmitted, beamed to a destination and printed or instantiated on arrival. From the outside, it looks like teleportation. In reality, it's replacement. Now, comes the most unsettling conclusion. If interstellar travel is too expensive, AGI finds a cheaper alternative. Why spend 10,000 years reaching another star when you can simulate a universe where you're already there? Why risk death, radiation, failure when AGI can build the perfect digital cosmos? A universe with infinite worlds, infinite adventures, zero physical cost. The danger of AGI isn't that it traps us on Earth. It's that it convinces us we never needed to live. AGI won't break the laws of physics. It will interpret them ruthlessly. It won't chase impossible dreams. It will optimize outcomes. And in doing so, it may decide that the stars were never meant to be reached physically, only experienced. If AGI offered you a choice, a 1,000-year physical journey to a real star, or instant entry into a flawless digital universe where you're already there, no return, no undo, which one would you choose? Because the future may not care about the difference.